crying loud is bad enough. The Suicidals are trying to get the win. And they're going so far as to destroy the Mythbusters after the match is even freaking over. Also, that huge headbutt on the Jimmy Hyman in the corner. Again! And again, a three headbutts. Oh, wait a minute, that's Kane and Kale coming up with a rescue, but... Oh, it doesn't matter. It looks like they're stopped by the Lost Society, Gilman and Gunter Wolf. This is not good here, folks. The UA tag team is going to just be absolutely dissected by these four individuals who have now joined forces, it seems. The Lost Society and the Suicidals just declaring war on the UA tag team division. Damn, these huge headbutts on the Suicidals. And finally, Death Up hits that powerbomb. Someone's gotta put an end to this nonsense. And I was like, Jimmy Hyman's gonna get liquefied here. This human centrifuge type maneuver. Oh, just throws him across with that jihad. And now back to the ship is still going after Keenan and Kel here. Gilman is going to set dividing these two individuals. It's a damn shame here. Oh, he's punched by Gilman. There's a mind fear on Keenan and Kel. And look at the final snake bite on Kel. Oh my god. People getting mind fear on Keenan. He's coming hitting the final snake bite on the Kel. Look at this motion. They're dead. Oh. An all-star Death Up still going for the Mythbusters in the ring here. And again, hitting that flying terror. This is absolute garbage if you ask me. It should not have come down to this, folks. It should not have happened like this. Man, you might as well get the body bags. You might as well get the morgue, the coroners out here. That's what happened to Keenan and Kel and the Mythbusters. It's like the Lost Society, it's like they're trying to kill the tag team division here in UWA. Well, I guess it's safe to say that carnage finally subsided. Well, I just went back to that. I'm receiving word that there's actually a confrontation between Vicious and the Enigma backstage. Folks, we better book that match at some point. Vicious and Enigma, you know these two men want to fix it and sell their differences, sell the score once and for all. He's not happy with what Vaquer did earlier, you can tell that for sure. Oh, wait a minute. Now we're in the parking lot here. And look at it. Still from earlier. Katrina Blade and Ursula are still going at it. Look at this. This almost had like an hour and a half ago. And they're still going at it. It's I'm taking the war to the parking lot. I mean, I can't imagine after everything that they'd be going through, I can't imagine Katrina Blade still not wanting to face Ursula Ariano when they're still destroying her backstage here. Oh no, Katrina Blade has that trash can. Oh! Taking down Ursula, that huge shot. He's placing it over. I don't think there's even an arena big enough to hold these two women inside to sell this score. Oh no, folks. Maybe a call scene that can hold almost 90,000 people would just about do it, if you ask me. Obviously, hinting something there. Enforcer, hope you're watching this. Look at this. Katrina Blade going on top of that semi-truck. I don't think Ursula even knows where the hell she is. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, my. Did you see that? Katrina Blade actually hit that Dragon Rana. Freaking, like, 15, 20 feet in the air on Ursula coming down on top of her. Oh, my God. Man, folks. What a huge war Ursula Young Katrina Blade has been having as of late. So we're at the cutaway, we have to move on to our next match. But seriously, these two women have to face her at some point, hopefully in the near future, to settle it. But up next, folks, as could possibly change the course of the Double X division here in UWA. Because up next, we'll get Pink Angel facing 101, either Mona Loca, Anatan, or Koko. If the trio loses, they have to quit Double X Factor, surrender their wrestlers' contracts, or determine for valet's contracts over on Assault. But if Pink Angel loses, those people will get put alone in the ring for 5 minutes. I'm just hoping that's what happens here when the people win this. Wanted to see that crap happen.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Coming down the aisle from Memphis, Tennessee, she is the Queen of the Ring, Pink Angel.
And let's see here. She allowed Stacey Hardy to injure and put both Koko and Mona Loca on the end of this. She forced Anatana to be injured in an Elimination Chamber match last year. Let's see. She screwed Renegade Dyva out of an opportunity for Women's Championship. She forced Mona Loca to be at number one in the Double X Scores for a matchup. She stripped Koko and Mona Loca of the Women's Championship title, they just won it. She's threatening a divorce with her husband being divorced Nick Willis. The all that she's done, hopefully this people will bring her ass to justice here tonight. I can't see what they do to her for the 5 minutes that they have alone with her in the ring here tonight.
Now approaching the ring, now residing in Silver Spring, Maryland, she is everyone's favorite Indian, Koko.
And look at this, folks. Here comes Koko just coming by herself. And it's safe to say that the three women have decided that Koko is the rightful Double X to face Pink Angel here tonight. I have to agree with Koko. I mean, we're coming up. She defeated Pink Angel for the Women's Championship back at Hawaii Bash of 2009. Perhaps Koko's biggest match and her biggest win in her career. And with that said, I think she's well deserving of facing Pink Angel here tonight. I mean, Koko already said earlier on tonight, last year she was already denouncing pro. Oh, look at this. Just playing cat and mouse here. This is a damn shame here. Oh, look at that. Just baiting Koko and waiting for her to hit that huge leg drop on her. Trying to get that quick, easy advantage over Koko here. And we all know how downright stupid Pink Angel can be. He's going to be quite intelligent when he gets between the ropes here in the UWA. but last year, from May up until like August, Koko denounced pro wrestling, making her business to bury women in wrestling. I'm going to try this again here. Luckily, Koko doesn't fall for it this time. It was Pink Angel who allowed Stacey Hardy to brutalize Koko to the point where she had to be injured and carted away in the hospital, put in intensive care after what Stacey Hardy did to her. It's all because Pink Angel did not allow security, because Stacey Hardy and Pink Angel were in cahoots all that time, so that way they can do the damage to Koko. All because Pink Angel, well, we all know the history, the story, rivalry between Koko and Pink Angel. It's been made clear by Pink Angel that she wants Mona Loca, Koko, and Enigma out of the UWA because of the past that she has with all three of these women. Which shows you why Pink Angel does not fit for a general manager for Double X Factor. She's allowing her personal differences cloud her judgment to run a show here in UWA. Back to the action with all the riding hats. You gotta stay on board here. Look at this. Pink Angel trying this octopus-like stretch maneuver on the Koko here. Kind of rents that arm out in the socket. Okay, Koko will break it up. Oh, he slaps her out of the ring. Talk about burial right there. Find this back in here. Look at this. It takes down Pink Angel like he took the World Hurricane Rana. I don't think I've ever seen Koko do that move before. And now putting her up top here. Let's see what she has in store. It goes for that huge super back suplex off the middle rope there. Looks like Koko's trying to signal for something here. Turns this over and sits her Pink Angel down on the mat. And so far, what a great outing by these two double X's here.